Take your time, take your time. On the shoulder.
Yeah, I can see the stick.
For a lot of people that live out in the country, hunting sort of second nature, particularly if they live on a bit of land and they can hunt off the back of the farm. For me, it's a real privilege. And I think that's lost on a lot of New Zealanders, that not many countries where you can just sort of, you know, get on the phone to someone you know, and they'll say, yes, scoot out here and come and shoot a stag. I mean, they're impressive animals, and around the world, they pay lots of money just for the right to go onto a bit of land and shoot an animal. They paid huge money. So for me, it's a huge privilege to be able to come and do this. And it's all because of connections, you know, people I've met along the way doing my job. And that's the best thing about my job, you know. I get to travel around the world, which is great, and see incredible things, but it's the people that I meet that is the very best part of it. And I met Chance and Randall on a shoot for ITM Hooked Me Up last year. We took them down to Fiordland. They had an incredible week, saw and did things that they'd never done before.
This has to be the trip of a lifetime, mate. Hey, unbelievable. The best way of describing it too is look at that.
And like most Kiwis, they just got in touch and they said, look, hey, if ever you want to go for a hunt, we've got a great block of land. And then they extended the offer and said, look, if ever you want to bring your son to shoot a deer, you're more than welcome to stay in the hut. And I've been lucky to have those sorts of offers from people up and down the country. Only this year, I blocked off a week of the school holidays. And I thought, no, bugger work. I'm going to go down there, and I'm so glad that we're here at the moment, and we're such a great group of people.
Well, we've got a big mission today. We're leaving the block that we've been hunting on, and we're going to be going through three different stations, covering, oh, I don't know, probably 30 or 40 odd kilometres. And we're going to be making our way right out to the coast. I haven't seen the ocean in 4 or 5 days, so looking forward to it.
Down here, it's just so different to what we have up in Northland. For starters, there's no deer up where we live. And that's a good thing, because if not for the pursuit of some wild venison, we wouldn't have made this long trip all the way down, and we wouldn't get to see this part of New Zealand. And it's also a good excuse to get the Can-Am out and put it through its paces and have a good hoon. But in all seriousness, without this machine, we just wouldn't be able to get into special places like this one.
Well, we've made it to the coast, and it's windy, cold, and the water looks filthy. Can't wait to get it. You fellas coming, eh? Yeah, come on.
And your undies.
In your undies. Or what fish are you going to catch?
Oh, rookhood.
Okay, come on. In your undies, boys. Power time.
Seemed like a good idea in front of the fire last night. We're going to be hyped from there, mate.
Yeah, so the water is a lot colder down here, and this coast gets pounded most of the year from wind and swell straight out of the Southern Ocean. But I guess that's why there's plenty of power here. But there's also some other good stuff, like cat's eyes, or poo-poos, as they're called.
Poo-poos, or cat's eyes, as they're known. Boil them up, get a drawing pin,
So now I'm completely numb, but I can still feel my way around the rocks to find power. And there is plenty of them here. The trouble is, you've just got to find some that are big enough. But I'm in here now, and I'm committed to getting us some seafood to go with our venison.
Oh, early!
No! Early! You bloody honkies!
Two bits of delicious right there. Nice big power and kinna.
Harl can go in the back later on, and the kinna can help fuel me for another, keep me going for another little while. The old kinna, crack an open, give it a shake, and that's the goodness right there. You can't eat kinna without making that noise, it's not possible. and that's how you do it when you get to a bit of isolated coast, it's just so plentiful. You boys gotta eat your tin as well, alright? Well, pretty cold right now. But nothing lifts the spirits like knowing you're going to have a good feed. Lunchtime. I think I'm going to use up my hot cup of tea right now. For lunch, a bit of protein, pepper steak, beef jerky, got my cream crackers to go on them. Tuna. Oh, it looks good. Your Go Native Matt Watson 24-hour food pack available now online. You've got your food sorted for 24 hours, three meals. The good one's still coming. That was Brit sales hitchy, wasn't it? Hunting time now. Come on, boys!
Bag in there.
Tucked off the road.
Way back there. 100 yards away. We can probably get our wind, I'd say.
Big bass. See that sort of cabbage tree up there in the.
Yeah.
Just on the edge of the Bulldoze track, he walked up the track behind it and went up that way.
So we're on our way back to the hunting block, and Glenn spots a big stag. And the farmer had told us that we might see one on the way out and to be ready. But we were ripping along on the bikes and we've spooked it, so it's got the jump on us. This is our last day here, and Shaw is the only one of us not to have shot a deer. And I did want him to have to work for it a bit. But if we don't find one and put him in front of it, he might miss out altogether. So we pushed back into the pines where we saw a stag on the first day we arrived here within an hour. And we turned that one down and it would have been an easy shot.
A couple of hinds run out across the track. I'm hoping there might be a stag here with him somewhere, but trouble, you're driving through, the bikes are noisy, they're probably long gone.
So we head back to have a look in that area, and we have to negotiate our way past a fallen tree, and there wasn't much room, and there was a nice steep drop-off on the side there if we got it wrong.
Made it, easy.
So we don't spook the deer, we decided to go on a couple of big walks through the pines, carefully looking around every corner, but we didn't see anything. So we'd move to another spot, and every time we jump back on the Can-Am, sure enough, we'd drive around the corner and there'd be a deer there and we'd spook it.
Look at the stags running. Look at that.
We've had a big day today. In fact, it's been a big few days. And the boys have had it. They're exhausted. But we decided to go for one last drive up the ridge to have a look out over the crop paddock where we saw the stag yesterday, because it might come out again. And really, it's all we've got. It's our last option.
No. It's in the same spot we saw that bigger one. Right, we've got to get right over the other side so we can take the bike so far, but then we're going to make too much noise, and then we have to go across the stream, up the ridge, and see if we can sneak up on them, mate.
Our last bit of light, so we've got to hook around the corner, get along the flat, jump out of the can and get up that ridge before it gets too dark for sure again.
So we're back to have a go at the same stag. Because he never really saw us or smelt us last time, it was only the ducks that blew our cover. He's come back out and he's in the same spot, the same time of the day. So we're making our approach and it looks like the ducks aren't there, but they are. They've seen us, and once again, they've blown our cover. And it's our last night here, and where we've seen all the animals has been in the evening. So, I mean, shore's dropped up a wee bit. I'm trying to keep his spirits up and say, hey, look, everyone's worked really hard for you today, boy. You know, everyone's, you know, been trying to spot these things, and we've approached it as best we can. But it's still not over. You know, we're going to be taking the Can-Am all the way back to the hut for our last night. And tonight, though, a little bit different. We're going to be shining the spotlight around to see if we can find something that Shaw's going to be able to shoot.
There.
Take your time. On the shoulder.
Got him.
Oh, yeah, got him.
It's a fellow too, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I wanted.
Hey, yeah, I reckon.
Yeah, boy. Yeah.
Oh, geez, it's all right.
8-pointer.
It's an 8?
Yeah.
It's a fellow. See, and you were getting a bit bloody long. You're getting a bit long in the mouth, hey? What did I say about not giving up?
Yeah, it's a beautiful animal.
It's beautiful, right? And tastes
even better. Yeah, and that's where you've got to pay respect to it, mate. Mm. You're taking a life, remember?
Yep.
So there it is. The boys have both got themselves a stag, a red for Max, a fellow for sure. Me and Glenn have shot an animal each as well, and it feels just right. Yeah, there's the big trophy, but that just gives us all the reason to come back. And in hindsight, that's probably a perfect place to leave it, you know. A good experience, good trip with great people, and a real big old wily stag to come back for.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so it did work out good missing that big one. And instead, I think we got a fair reward for the effort we put in. But more importantly, the boys got to have a good experience. Not just the hunting, but learning about the land, the animals, processing the meat, and just helping out with the cooking and cleaning around the hut.
Before we scoot back to the hut to clean up and thank everybody there in person, and of course we'll be giving a very big thank you to Ben, who's hosted us here on this block of land.
Hide from the camera.
And Randall and Chance, of course, for putting in their time to show us Northland guys around. So big thanks to them. And of course, we've got a big shout out to Can-Am. This just would not have been doable without the vehicle here. Hunting and Fishing New Zealand got us decked out in the right gear. And of course, we've popped in and seen a few of the lads on the way down. And they're always very forthcoming with some advice. So cheers for that. And our food that's been powering us for the trip, Go Native. Check out those 24-hour food packs online. Thank you, everyone. We'll be back next year.